Morning, church. The Monday after Resurrection Sunday. I hope you're doing well today. I'm thinking a lot this morning about what the disciples of Jesus would have thought the Monday after Resurrection Sunday. After they woke up that morning, their eyes opened, their first cogent thoughts came to their mind, and I would have imagined that their entire world would be different. Here's a question. What would those disciples of Jesus have feared on this Monday, the day after the resurrection of Jesus? Think about it. Would they still be afraid of the Romans? Would they be afraid of death? Would they be afraid of persecution? Would they be afraid of broken dreams or not living up to their full potential? What honestly would they be afraid of? After all that they had witnessed Jesus go through, all that he had promised them, what would they be afraid of? Even Mary Magdalene, Mary, the mother of James, Salome, the women, even Mary, Jesus's mother. What would they be afraid of? I want to encourage you in these videos as we come each week or a couple times a week to tend your heart. That's the main purpose of these, because in this time of uncertainty, in this time of constant change, in this time of a massive flow of information, there are a lot of distractions for your heart and mind. You've probably noticed that you can easily go throughout the whole day being busy, being consumed, and not really do much worthwhile. That's just the nature of this time. And so in order to fight against that, I want to constantly and consistently remind you why it's important to tend your own heart spiritually. And there are two reasons at least. One, it's good for you. It's good for your heart and mind. And two, it's so good for you that you are better equipped, more healthy, to bless others well when you tend your heart. And to do that, we've been walking through the Psalms. I'm not gonna read all of Psalm 27 today, another Psalm of David, but I encourage you to do so. So if you've got your Bibles, I'll give you a second to grab Psalm 27. We're just gonna read a few verses, try to set the bar for you. So Psalm 27, give you a second, are you ready? Psalm 27 is the Psalm of David. He says this, "The Lord is my light and my salvation, whom shall I fear?" You see, he's talking about fear. And on the Monday after Easter, I think fear was not as strong as it was the day before. I think fear in general is not and should not be as strong in us as it would be on Friday, the day Jesus died, after Sunday when he raised. Now, David, of course, is writing 1,000 years before Jesus, but he says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation, whom shall I fear?" We're reading it this side of the cross. We have to ask ourselves that question. "The Lord is the defense of my life. Whom shall I dread? When evildoers come upon me to devour my flesh, my adversaries and my enemies, they stumbled and fell. Though a host encamp against me, my heart will not fear. Though war arise against me, in spite of this, I shall be confident." And then David, starting in Psalm 27, verse 4, he really focuses on intimacy with God in a specific location, in the tabernacle, in the place where the Lord lived and dwelt on the earth in the time of David. He says, "One thing I've asked and that from the Lord, and that shall I seek." And then he goes on to name three things, but they're all one thing, and that is to dwell in the presence of God, to be intimate with God's presence. "So one thing I've asked from the Lord, and that shall I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to meditate in his temple. For in the day of trouble, he will conceal me," listen, "in his tabernacle, in the secret place of his tent, he will hide me. He will lift me up on a rock." When things get rough, David says, in the day of trouble, the presence of God will surround him and protect him. I love Psalm 27 for many reasons, but one of those reasons is because it's very relevant for our and your situation today. Look at verse 11. This is what it says. "Teach me your way, O Lord, and lead me in a level path because of my foes." Here's, I think, what David is revealing to us. And he reveals to you through this living psalm written by the Holy Spirit of God through David in this time and even endures to today. He knew something that we need to understand, that in times of anxiety, in times of pressure, in times of attack from external or even internal fear and conflict, in those times we tend to act out of the flesh. We tend to not operate in the spirit. We tend to act out of the flesh. That's why David in verse 11, he says, "Teach me your way, O Lord, and lead me in a level path because of my foes." He says, because I'm under pressure, I know my heart and I know I tend to act out of the flesh. So God, I need you even more in this time of anxiety and pressure. Now, I think that's very relevant for us. So we can pray verse 11, all of Psalm 27, but especially verse 11, because of this time, Father, lead me in a level path. Teach me your ways. Tend your heart in this time, dear friend. One, because it's healthy for you. It's good for you. And two, it equips you to better bless and be a blessing to others. Read all of Psalm 27. I hope it blesses you. I hope it encourages your heart. I hope it lifts your head. And I hope it even more than ever wipes fear away in your heart and in your mind. I love you, church. Be blessed. Hope to see you soon.